सभी परेशानियों का अभी सभी दुखों से रहे होंगे हम हमारे आने वाले एक जिंदगी हम लोग बहुत शांति चार सौ भी आए और हमारा भी बहुत जीवन जो इसी So I'd like to welcome all the students for this wonderful occasion. It is open for all our students. And we are celebrating our long time with the students. So, और साधन और सुंदर ओम नमो भगवते वसुदेवाय। So this very famous pastime of Lord Krishna picking up the golden hill is narrated by Sukadeva Goswami just after he had told about the Yajna Brahmanas and how the Yajna Brahmanas had not offered any service for Krishna. So the wants to bring out the importance of offering pure devotional service to Lord Krishna without any desire to worship any other god other than Krishna. We know that there are a lot of gods and people do have a tendency to worship other gods, but those who are in full knowledge of the absolute truth will worship simply Lord Krishna. Well, worship of other gods is tolerated. We should understand that the worship of other gods will bring results which are limited and
temporary.
And
house of safety, very clean environment in that. But whatever benedictions are given by other gods can only be given with the sanction of the Supreme Lord Shri Krishna. So then Sukadeva Goswami goes on to describe how one day Lord Krishna observed how Nanda Maharaj and the powerful men of Vrindavan were preparing a yajna for the worship of Indra. At this time, Lord Krishna was 7 years of age, like a child, and he inquired from his father, he wanted to know from Nanda Maharaj, what is the purpose of this yajna? Who are you worshiping? What do you want to worship? How are you going to do it? Nanda Maharaj initially did not respond to the question of Lord Krishna. He thought, my son's just a title. He won't be able to understand. But Lord Krishna persisted. Lord Krishna told his father that don't keep secrets between us. We're the same family. There's no reason to keep things a secret. Please tell me, Frank, honestly, what is this about? Nanda Maharaj began to explain that this is a sacrifice which we perform every year. He said, actually, it's not really Shastra. It's actually more looking. It's one of the traditions in our community. But Nanda Maharaj continued, we're Vaishyas, we depend on rain. Rain is very important for agriculture. Without rain, we cannot produce crops, we don't have grass, we cows. So rain is very important. That rain is all under the administration of Indra. He is the god of rain. Nanda Maharaj explained that we want to thank Indra for providing the rain. The clouds are under his administration, and he sends clouds full of water to pour on the fields so that we can perform our agriculture and so that we can have nice grass to the clouds. So we have to show our gratitude, we have to show our appreciation to Indra, who's the king of heaven and God of rain. Lord Krishna understood the nature of Indra, that Indra was actually proud. The his position, and he considers himself independent of the city of Mars. And he was considered in the Atman to be for his own pleasure. Lord Krishna doesn't like to see his devotees become crowds. So Lord Krishna wants to remove the pride of this Indra, and he begins by first of all convincing Nanda Maharaj that he should not perform this Indra yet. Lord Krishna explains to Nanda Maharaj a philosophy which is called Karma Mimamsa. This is one of the well-known doctrines, especially a philosophy propagated by Vishnu. But it takes away the ultimate mood that there is a supreme law over everything. Lord Krishna told Nanda Maharaj, you don't have to worship Indra. He's not going to do anything unless you do your duty. Your duty purchase is important, Lord Krishna told Nanda Maharaj. We get the result by performing our own duty, your work, what's expected of us. The result will then come. It's not just bringing the we should understand. Lord Krishna is speaking this common mantra philosophy. He doesn't really believe it, but he's just using this word after a very honorable Nanda Maharaj to convince him of this tender that. Srila Prabhupada gives us some arguments to help us understand the defect of this common concept philosophy. He explains that if just simply doing your duty will bring you the results, then it should happen that if a sick person goes to the doctor and gets medicine, takes the treatment, then he should be cured. But it doesn't always happen. You may be sick, you may take the medicine, you may follow all the instructions of the doctor, and you still never
cure.
It's not enough to escape medicine, have a good doctor.
Even if you have the last one or
He said, just like mother and father, they may do everything to bring up their children in a nice way and make their children good character and good people. But still, the children may not be good. It's not just about fathering. So it's not just by giving your children, not just simply by work alone to get results. You need all of the blessings from the Supreme Lord. So Lord Krishna went on to tell his father that you don't need to worship in your name. You can see the rain falling everywhere. It falls on the ocean. There's so much water on the ocean there. If the ocean doesn't worship Indra, there's still a rain there. So Lord Krishna had been seeing himself in this world 5,000 years ago, and he didn't like to see the people in the holy land of Vrindavan worshiping other gods, worshiping different gods to get material results. Lord Krishna comes in this world to establish the highest principle of religion, and that is to surrender to Krishna completely, not to surrender to any other person other than Krishna. Krishna is going to see his own devotees in the land of Vrindavan worship. So Lord Krishna convinced Nanda Maharaj that you don't need to worship Indra. You should simply worship this Govardhan hill and the cows and the Brahmanas. They are the ones who gave you that. You don't need to worship Indra. We may be surprised. Why worship Golden Hill? What's so special about the Golden Hill? We have to understand what is the glory of the Golden Hill. In Srimad Bhagavatam, in the chapter Veda Vita, you can hear the gopis glorify the Golden Hill. They describe the Golden Hill as Hari Dasa Vanya, the very best of all the devotees of Lord Hari. The name was called Hari Das. Of course, we know Nama Anarya Hari Das Thakur, who was that was an incarnation of God the Mother. And then also Prahlad Maharaj, who was the Hari Das. And Maharaj Yudhisthira is the author of the incarnation of Hari Das. But this is over the angle. This is over the angle. This is, I think, the last of the very best of the Lord of Heaven. Why is it the best? Because it does so much for the Lord. Provides many for the So this golden hill is often called the Giriraj, the king of all the mountains, the best of all the mountains, because he is both Krishna and at the same time he is Krishna. He is engaging in to offer his own service for the pleasure of Lord Krishna and for the pleasure of all the cows, all the who come there on the border. As waterfalls, which provide deep, very sweet, cooling, and fragrant water to be pushed and be drunk by the cows. And also the cow was can refresh himself with the water which flows from the waterfalls and over the hill.
So, I am Mr. Martin, without the water bodies.
The Govardhan also provides very succulent and refreshing grass, which is very pleasing to the cows. When the cows are eating very nice grass, then they're happy to produce more and more milk. Govardhan also produces many nice fruits from the trees which grow there on the Govardhan. And then there are also roots which are very soft and then pleasing to the cows and the cows.
What have you done?
There are also caves on the Govardhan Hill, which are shelter for the copper boys when there's a heavy windstorm or when it gets too hot, that they can go into the cave shelter.
Okay. सारे बाल बाल
There also there is special passage by which they can also the And just to understand more of the nature of Govardhan Hill, the stones on Govardhan Hill, and in the winter time, when it's very cold, the stones will be warm on their feet. But in the summer time, when it's very hot, the stones on Govardhan will be cooling.
और ठंड में वो गर्म गर्मी
And in the time of the path of the manifestation of Shiva and in the But the you do not walk on the border, you simply walk around. When the devotee came from Vrindavan to Jagannathpuri and brought the Govardhan Shiva and gave him to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very happy. He kept the Shiva with him for several months. And every day, sometimes he would put it on his head, sometimes he would hold it in front of his eyes, other times he would simply look at it and let it be a dream.
Thank you.
Later on, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu presented the temple of Shiva, one of his disciples, rather than that of Mami, and rather than that of Mami, so it was customary that before you take a stone from the over there, you should get a stone.
So you are sitting from the other side.
And when you take the stone from the lower rectum, you are expected to replace it with an equivalent weight of gold. Anyway, Lord Krishna was convincing his father, Nanda Maharaj, we won't worship Indra. Let's not worship Indra. Let's just worship Govardhan. Nanda Maharaj said, oh, we can do both. Let's do both. But Krishna said, no, there's not enough time. Lord Krishna explained the worship of this Lord and the Lord would take all the fat that you have got so far and more. We need much more to worship over than no problem. You have to prepare very nicely all kinds of varieties of food stuffs to offer the food. And Lord Krishna Mahaprabhu described all the different dances for the function of there should be gulabs and sandesh, rasgulla, and samosa, and choli, and puri, and halva, and sweet rice. So many Lord Krishna wanted very different.
So the part of the is such a good party.
So then the power of the people, they have to submit to Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna, the one they love more than anyone, they want to exist for. So we think, all right.
One,
And when they compare with everything, then they offer everything to Gilgamesh over that. At the time, Gilgamesh appeared. He appeared with an arm and he began to eat everything which he prepared. There were mountains of sweet falls and rivers of chutney, and so many different substances. Over them came was devouring everything. He was saying, Ani or, bring more,
bring more. So, wow, this song,
And if you still see any more, they're thinking, oh my goodness, how could we understand?
We can eat
so much. So Govardhan was happy, but Indra was very angry because he didn't get his Ratna. He was very angry. So he ordered the summer power clouds, which usually only come at the end of the time of the annihilation of the universe. And he ordered the summer power clouds, you go and bring down and annihilate. You flood the whole of it now, wipe out all the civilization
there. So,
So the sun went up the clouds coming, and they were followed by Indra, who came riding on his elephant. The sun went up the clouds, made the whole of Vrindavan black. It was just like night. It was very cold. It was just very cold, icy wind. And then there was rain, which was frozen in icicles falling from the sky. It became very frightening and fearful for all the people of the town.
So, for the bottom line, or is not the leader behind?
So when the people of Vrindavan are in any danger, they only turn to Krishna. They can't think of anyone else. But whatever danger is there, it doesn't matter if some demon, they may. They will come, or maybe this happening comes at the break, or maybe it's the father's fire, but in every situation, people are going down, they will always turn to Krishna. So Lord Krishna, this is the word of Indra. And when the people of Vrindavan are walking into Vrishwamata, then Lord Krishna made arrangements for that. He went to have the over the hill and he found up with a little finger, left hand, just like he did here, how he's holding the golden hill with his left hand, with one little finger, he's holding the golden hill. And he calls all the people, come under the hill and bring the cows with you. So the, another feature of this golden diva is that by taking up the golden hill, Lord Krishna is able to satisfy the desires of the gopis, because the gopis always desire to be able to be more with Krishna, be looking at Krishna constantly. So when Krishna brings up the golden hill, at that time, all the gopis would overcome under the hill, and they could, without any difficulty, could be looking at Krishna constantly for 7 days and 7 nights.
What is the matter of my mind?
So the gopis and young women in the village of Vrindavan, they're very much obliged to the Shodhasthi. Another group of young men, they all desire to look at Krishna. That was very difficult for them. Their parents, don't go look at Krishna. Stay away from Krishna. But when Krishna picked up the Lord and then the time we all work on Krishna to be there with Krishna and fill their eyes, their full sight, and they sing Krishna. So although Indra was showering torrents of rain and thunder and lightning, the so terrible storm, the people of Vrindavan were all saved because Krishna was holding up over them. The golden hill was doing another service on behalf of Krishna. It was being like an umbrella protecting all the people of Vrindavan from the anger of the new. And just 7 days, nights, then Indra was on. Because he was not going to win. The Lord Krishna. And then Lord Krishna saw the storm over. He invited all the people and down come out from under the hill, and Lord Krishna put the hill back in position. So of all the people they were jubilant. They were discussing this Krishna. They think maybe he's a happy person. Nanda Maharaj, he would tell them, "You don't know my son, who did them our other child. You don't know how I'm going to be here. They always give me money. I don't believe no. But we always have to overcome the I mean, Mother Yashoda, she's thinking, I don't think really my son would pick them up over the hill. I think it must have been the father. Must have been another father. How would my son be? Only a little boy.
So we see closely in the Baba and the Baba and the Baba and the Krishna.
We have to understand the emperor of Vrindavan, the special nature of the Vrindavan people. That in Vrindavan, they don't think of Krishna as God. They think of Krishna as their child, or as their friend, or as their the most. But the always is more loved by Pranamda Shura and the Shabu, who was the cowherd boys, Sudama and Sridam, he's the best friend. So this is yoga mind. The people in Vrindavan, they're under yoga mind. They don't see Krishna as the Lord of the food. They don't see God. They don't see him as one of the brahmins, as a friend, or as a paternal, or as a lord.
We do fire from the home, we do fire from the home.
So by grace to Lord Krishna, then Indra was crushed, Indra became humble, and he realized he committed a great offense, and then later on he came back with the Surabhi power, and he offered Krishna and glorified him, and Indra and Tandra. Indra at that time declared Lord Krishna to be the real Indra. He said, people call me Indra, I'm not really. Indra when you keep that I'm not really. You are the real. You are the real. So every year, the devotees of Krishna and which of course takes place to the family of the body, and this holy month, and we can all celebrate by creating another golden hill, and we offer our worship to this golden hill, and we worship the golden hill. And later on, we are also going to distribute this over and all on some of it. Someone was asking me that they didn't proper for us to eat the Govardhan because the Govardhan is Krishna. So is it proper if we put it in a mouth or eat it? Well, the Govardhan Hill is also Krishna, and the prasadam is also Krishna. So when you get prasadam, you eat it, without it. We don't necessarily honor prasadam. So in the same way, when they give some of the Govardhan Hill, we honor prasadam. We honor them for the respect that's founded in the Lord Krishna. This festival of Lord and Puja is celebrated by the devotees. And then everywhere they present, they create a lot of work, a lot of prasadam distributed to everyone without discrimination, without distinction.
Sabu
in the dogs, in the dogs, we think not only the cows, especially for the dogs, but we also honor all living men, we give them all the chance to relish the abundance and flourish of the Lord's So Diwali, that was the festival generally considered that to be the day in which Balaram came out of exile after spending 14 years in the forest. Then he returned to Ayodhya along with Sita and Lakshman. After the battle of Lanka and after rescuing Sita, Lord Rama was eager to go back to Ayodhya and to be reunited with his brother Bhara.
So, Lanka and
so he asked the vision. The brother of Ram, Lord Rama took the vision on the shore of Lanka. He was asking the vision, how should I go? What if I could be perfect for each day by Ayodhya? So the vision said, you can take Ram's Pushpa Vamana. He has said, one of the acres of death is very good. Thank you for the Pushpa Vamana. He was approached by Sukriva, and Sukriva said, I don't want to go with you. Can I come? Can I come to Ayodhya with you? And Lord Rama said, no, you cannot bring all the other monkeys, you can all come with me.
You
have to understand Pushpa Vamana is not like the Emirates airline or the flying bar or anything like that. The Pushpa Vamana is a beautiful pleasure garden and it causes thousands of people.
Yeah,
So all the monkeys were able to get away to see the Ram and Lakshman, and they were flying by. And when they were flying back, they saw the fish coming. And they picked up all the family, all the monkeys, and all the lions also. And they all took human forms also. Then you wish that some drops from the top of Golden Hill may fall on you, or you may even be bitten by poison snakes who may live in the Golden Hill. If you don't possess the Golden Hill, these inauspicious things may happen to you.
इसकी प्रतिमा नहीं होगी, उसके लिए भी और बाकी लोग इस बात पर बैठे हैं।